Now, your local weather with the KX Storm Team.
Welcome back to Good Day Dakota. It's 6:18 on this Tuesday, and you're waking up to some pretty cold temperatures.
Yeah, it's really chilly out there. The chilliest I've seen in quite some time, but they'll quickly rebound as we go through the day. Good. So we'll get to that in just a second. Right now, let's take a look outside to the Magic City, where darkness is still overspreading the entire region, about an hour or 90 minutes away from sunrise today. A nice shot of Minot, which, like many cities across the region, is one of the chilly spots. You are at 22 degrees this morning, waking up in Minot, humidity of 75%. 28 degrees, a little bit warmer in Dickinson, those southeast winds at 11 miles an hour, making your wind chill just 18 degrees. So it feels a little bit colder than it actually is. Not the case in Williston, 21 degrees is your temperature, humidity at 78%. And as you wake up this morning in Bismarck, you are greeted with a temperature of 21 degrees. Your pressure is 30.36 inches of mercury. Elsewhere across the region, temperatures remain in the mid-20s on average. Couple exceptions, cool spots. Harvey, you're at 18, 19 degrees now in Watford City and Garrison. The warm spot, Hettinger, you are at 30 degrees. Wind's not too bad this morning. Mostly light and variable. The exception right now is Dickinson out of the southeast at 12 miles an hour. We'll put Precision Cast into motion here to tell you about that rainfall that may be coming. Tuesday, or today actually, should be nice and dry, but clouds will be on the increase. You can see those there coming from the south as we go through the day. We're going to have a system that's going to mostly slide by to the south, but it's going to tap some moisture from the Gulf of Mexico, which will ignite a few showers as we go through the day on Wednesday. Not a complete washout. They should be quickly through the area. I think for the most part, Thursday should be dry, maybe some scattered clouds around, and then our next chance for precipitation rolls in here Friday. Again, none of these days are going to be a complete washout, and then more rain enters the region for early portions of the weekend. Again, that's Saturday. A lot can change between now and then, so we'll be fine-tuning that forecast as we approach. In terms of how much rainfall we can expect from those showers, again, not much. I think mostly eastern sections, a trace to a quarter of an inch of rain, so nothing that's too concerning. What is concerning is Hurricane Willa, which was a Category 5 storm in the eastern Pacific. You can see that tight little pinhole eye around that center of circulation moving toward the Mexican coast. Now a Category 3 storm, but definitely a disaster headed for the western Mexico coast. Today in Bismarck, your forecast looks like this, 51 degrees. Clouds will slowly be on the increase, and winds will also be on the increase, gusting to 20 miles an hour. Mostly clear in Minot and Williston today with 50 degrees as your high. Will be breezy at times. Highs across the region today will range from the mid to upper 50s. A few portions of the region could touch 60 degrees. Not the case for northern sections, especially toward the northeast, where you may struggle to even get to 50 degrees. Temperatures tonight will drop into the 30s, 37 in Bismarck and Dickinson with those light winds. Clouds continue to be on the increase, and 34 your low tonight in Minot and Williston. It'll take a little bit longer for those clouds to increase up to the north. Your extended forecast for Bismarck and Dickinson looking like this. There's that chance for showers on Wednesday with some breezy conditions. 20% chance on Friday. Temperatures nice and seasonable. The same applies for Minot and Williston, Tim. Just a chance for scattered rain with seasonable temperatures.
All right. Glad to see we're in the average range here now.
Bingo.
Thanks, Robert. Keep it with us on Good Day Dakota. Here's what's coming up. This nice fall weather is giving farmers a chance to catch up. We'll take you out into the field. And two Republican candidates stopped by Dickinson State University to talk about a host of topics. Full details are coming up soon.